Quill's muscles ached, and her eyes grew heavy. She decided it best to set up camp and rest before journeying onto the castle.
Hey, kid. Good. You're alive.
The starling spoke as it circled the campfire. Quill gasped in shock as the starling unveiled monstrous wings and curled horns. It descended, talons gleaming.
Oh dear, I didn't mean to scare you.
I'm not scared, Quill replied. I just didn't know starlings were feathered.
This starling thing's gotta go, kid. The name's Adurin. No. We aren't feathered. Only me. I'm working on it. Let's just say, choosing the wrong friends comes with the price. But you seem like a good friend to have.
Thanks, I think.
Quill readied her meal and paused to take in the strange winged creature who now called her friend. As a field of stars bloomed over the sky, their campfire conversations deepened.
He's all I have. If I lose him, I don't know what I'll do, confided Quill.
Adurin looked down at his wings.
If I help you find him, can you help me?
If we can, we will, Starling. I mean, Adurin.
Although Quill was far from the safety and comfort of her nook in the cottage, her exhaustion led her into a deep sleep.
Hey, Ghostface. A lot of folks have been waiting for a reader like you to return. I know I have. I'm going to scout the castle up ahead. Keep her safe, okay? For both our sakes.
Durin was nowhere to be found, but looming high on a distant bluff was the castle, a stark reminder of what mattered most. Quill drew a deep breath and readied herself for the journey ahead. Upon their return, it was evident the toad had not warmed to their company.
You really really are asking for it. When they fail this second test, dibs on the runt for dinner.
He muttered, to no one in particular. I've heard through my little buds that you've made great strides on your journey. The voice rang from the wood. But the true test of twofold requires mastery from you both.
I knew they'd give up.
Chortled. I've heard through my little buds that you've made great strides on your journey. The voice rang from the wood. But the true test of twofold requires mastery from you both.
The Arcane are enraged by your bond. The stronger it becomes, the harder you'll be to defeat. Reader, through this sword, Quill can channel your energy. Be steadfast with this one, Rita. Advise the voice. Things will get difficult. But you mustn't close the book on your hero. Quill felt more assured, more ready for the dangers of the castle. The toad, however, was not yet impressed.
Still just a rodent in champion's clothes, if you ask me. Doubt they'll find the last portal back here. Thank you.